Hey guys, what is up? It is your friendly neighborhood Ubus here, back again with another Isaac Bringer, and this time we're gonna start with Cricket's body again, I know. Listen, I hate to keep explaining myself, but I've now shown how I you know, get a seed, you know? That's the way I get a seed is through resetting for hours on end, depending on how the seeds are cooperating. And I'll tell you right now, the seeds are not cooperating. So, I've just had a fucking string of really uncooperative pieces of shit, and so we're going with a lot of repeat items. And I apologize for that, but there ain't shit I can do. If there was, obviously I would do it. But there ain't. So I ain't doing it. Sure. Alright, so let's fucking go. Firstly, I have something I want to say regarding World of Warcraft content. I am probably going to be uploading some World of Warcraft videos. I know a few people have shown interest, and I streamed it a few days last week, this week, whatever. I streamed like 7 days in a row or something, and I was streaming WoW a good chunk of the time, Hearthstone the other chunk of the time, but, so I'll probably be uploading some WoW content. Just wanna let you know that this will not ever, once again, reminding you, no additional content will ever, ever, ever decrease the amount of content that I'm currently producing. The only thing that'll decrease the amount of content I'm currently producing are completely, you know, opposite side of the spectrum factors. It's not going to be anything related to me really just, you know, uploading extra shit. That's what it is. At the end of the day, it's extra. So, you're welcome. But, anyway, now that that's out of the way, I will let you guys know that I am rewatching Dragon Ball Z. I haven't watched any DBZ since my fucking childhood, and so far, I'll tell you something. I am already remembering how much goddamn filler there was. Cause there's a fuckload of filler in DBZ. Holy shit. Like, I'm on like episode 16 or whatever, right? And if you don't know, oh wow, that's real good. The first DBZ saga, the first arc of Dragon Ball Z, not Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z, because I never really liked Dragon Ball. Obviously, it sets up the story and shit, blah, 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 blah. I'm not going to rewatch Dragon Ball in order to rewatch Dragon Ball Z, alright? I can remember the setup for Dragon Ball Z. Anyway, what was I saying? Anyway, right, so I'm on, like, episode 15 or 16 or something, and the first saga is the, did that break something? I hope not. Alright, it probably looked weird for a second. I hit F, I fat-fingered F, which makes the game go full screen, so. But, it's the Saiyan Saga, which is where Goku finds out that he's Kakarot and shit. Also, I'm not gonna fucking hold off on spoilers. This is Dragon Ball fucking Z. If you haven't seen DBZ, I'm so sorry for your loss. But, anyway, he finds out he's fucking Kakarot and blah-di-blah-di-blah, they kill Raditz, and then, you know, Vegeta and, what's his fucking face? Nappa? Head to Earth, which takes a year. Now, in these episodes that I've watched so far, the amount of content is very low. The amount of bullshit happening for the sake of, you know, increasing the runtime, I suppose, is very high. And I know why this is. I've heard why it is. It's because they had to just, like, stall. The people making the anime had to stall while waiting for the manga, right? Or the manga. Because they didn't want to just, like, make their own shit and find out, you know, all the blah, blah, blah. They had to wait, right? They had to wait. And, because of that, they had to figure out a way to stall, basically. So they did it a lot. A lot of times, you know, people make jokes about the whole, like, three episodes later, like, you know, and that's honestly fairly true, but, there's so much filler, it's brutal, actually. It's like, they'll be here in a year, Goku, you better fucking blah, do the thing, train with fucking whoever, yeah, King Kai, right? Yeah. You gotta go training, and then he's like, alright, tell them not to revive me with the Dragon Balls until a year from now, blah, 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 right? And then, you know, four episodes, he's on the fucking stupid road bridge thing that's in this heaven place in order to get to King Kai to fucking train. And it's not like that was the end of it. It's not like he was just on there for four episodes. He's gotta keep going, man. He hasn't gotten there yet. And then he fell off the fucking bridge and... oh, jeez. And then there's the fucking Gohan bit where he's left out alone in the wilderness by Piccolo. Blah, blah, blah. A lot of bullshit kind of went on to stall for when Vegeta and Nappa show up, basically. And obviously they had a perfect plot setup for it because, oh sweet, hell yeah. They had a great plot setup for it because, of course, it took a year to travel from wherever the fuck they were to Earth. I don't remember where they were. It wasn't the Saiyan home planet because that shit blowed the fuck up. But yeah, I'm rewatching it. And you know what? I am enjoying it. I really am. But it's brutal how much filler there is. That's why, like, I've been playing WoW in the background, just farming shit to get gold, basically. The whole time in the background. And, I mean, it's been working pretty well. I'm at, like, 30k gold right now or something. And raid reset just happened, so I'll probably be at, like, 40k gold by the end of the day or something. It'll be pretty sweet. I'm looking forward to it. And the cool thing about WoW is that now that they've introduced the WoW token, which is a thing, you can buy it from the shop for 20 bucks, right? Like the real money shop for 20 bucks. And then you can sell it on the auction house for gold. And the gold depends on your region. All regions, well, each region has the same price across the entire thing. So in Americas, it's always the same. It's a certain price. And the price does fluctuate in the region based on supply and demand, basically. They have some formula behind it. But basically, the amount of gold you can buy it for is, on US, is around 27k gold right now. And the thing that the WoW token does is it lets you get a month of playtime, which is normally $15. So the person who has extra money, not a lot of gold, right, who basically they have a full-time job, right, for those people who want gold, they just, you know, buy this thing, get gold, right? Easy peasy. And for the people who don't have a full-time job and have a shitload of time, but not money because, you know, no job, it's great because you can keep playing WoW just by utilizing your time to farm gold and buy the token. It's a sweet system. Also, it, oh god, yes. Also, it has, severe, well, it had, maybe not severe, but it had a reasonable impact on the botting and, gold selling, quote, community, if you will. A negative impact from their perspective, of course, because it's against terms of service, and Blizzard wants to remove it, obviously. And it makes sense that it would take a hit from this system. It wasn't huge. People still do it and sell gold for cheaper than the WoW token, but at least in this way, if you just, you know, want to say fuck it, you can just do the thing with the WoW token, and you can get your money, and you won't be breaking terms of service and risk your account getting suspended and all that shit. It's great. It's like win-win, win-win-win situation, right? Chocolate milk is awesome. I like chocolate milk. Jesus. It's a powerful, powerful thing, isn't it? Alright, fuck this. So basically what I've been doing, because I got a 3 month resub, because if you go 1 month resub, it's $15. If you go, what is it, 6 month resub? Here, I have a plan, a cunning plan. Shit. Alright. Took slightly too long. Oh well. It's not like I lost anything. It was the exact same as if I just left. But yeah, so I got the 3 month resub, which was a little over a month ago, I believe. Yeah, it had to be just a little over a month ago, because it was the end of the month. In whatever the fucking month was prior to the month that we just ended. Anyway, I don't pay the most attention. I could look on my computer and find out for you momentarily, but that would require me to do things. Fuck that shit. But, yeah, so just over a month ago is when I resubbed. I currently have 3 level 100s. I think I have just over, like, probably... Wait. No, I think I have, like, 35k gold in total across my characters right now. Which is pretty good, because I only really started gold farming very recently. Like, not even a week ago. But, yeah, so basically I have 2 months left. Ooh, I'm gonna just pop that shit. Ooh, I mean, that's great and all, but not enjoyable. This is perfect, as is this. Yeah, so basically I have 2 months left, and then I'll probably just be rolling on WoW tokens, if I had to guess, for the foreseeable future. Unless I suddenly get a time sink known as a job. It's not like I'm not trying to get a job, by the way. Just want to throw that out there. Because I don't know, I'm sure when certain people hear, like, that, you know, somebody else is unemployed, their first instinct is, oh, you lazy sack of shit! You know? And I don't blame them. There's a lot of lazy sacks of shit. And I wouldn't personally distance myself very far from them. But I at least, I do put effort into attempting to find a job. The issue is that, well, there's a lot of issues. It's a very complicated situation for me, alright? I'd rather not go into it. I'd rather spare you the details. I mean, I've talked about, like, my whole anxiety thing before, so nothing that should be very bizarre. It's just that there's a lot. I might actually someday just make a video just covering fucking me, you know, just talking about me, because I'm sure there are people who are curious about stuff, and I definitely haven't gone the what some would call standard route of living their life. Sweet. Yeah, let's just leave. We already took both items from the double deal. I didn't bother checking, obviously. Ugh. Able. Ugh. Ugh. Blech. Yeah, basically, I'm enjoying the shit out of WoW. And it's so funny, too, because when I resubbed, I was like, alright, I'm gonna resub for 3 months. At the end of those 3 months, if I still really enjoy WoW, I'll keep playing it, I'll keep the subscription up, right? And part of it had to be the fact that the WoW token existed. And I was like, alright, you know, if I do enjoy it, I don't have to keep throwing away my precious few dollars every month. And then here I am, like, not even a little over a month in, and I'm like, yeah, no, I'm planning on playing WoW forever. So that's cool. Trinkets, huh? You a trinket machine, motherfucker? Listen, dude. There you go. Thank you. Much better. And, like, the funny thing is, going into WoW, right? Coming back into WoW, my initial instinct based on everything that I had read, everything people have said about WoW, that I've read online and shit, I was like, oh man, WoW probably sucks, and it's just my fucking nostalgia glasses making me remember it fondly. God, WoW sucks! And then I played it and I was like, oh no, those people are just fucking idiots. Okay, cool, nice. I'll enjoy playing my video game while they enjoy whining about the video game that they don't play anymore. And apparently need to be heard on like a primal level of need. Like, yeah, there's bad things in WoW, sure. Yeah, they've lost like 5 million subs. They're still above 5 million, as we know, as of recently. But like, fuck, dude, who doesn't do shit wrong? What company doesn't do shit wrong with a video game that they create? Because the answer is none. All video games have issues. They do. Every fucking video game I've ever played has had negative aspects. Welcome to the fucking real world, where nothing's perfect. And so, I don't let a few negatives just outweigh the positives, you know? It's the same thing with fucking movies and shit. Like, anybody can just say, oh, this part was bad. That requires nothing. That requires no thought, that requires no effort, and even more, it doesn't do anything. It's not beneficial to anybody involved at all. Just saying, oh, this thing sucked. Right? What does that do? It does nothing. It's like, oh, okay. I now know that your opinion is this thing was bad. Got it. Understood. I now understand that if I would like to cater to exactly you, I should just not have this, right? Not I should change this, I should just not have this, because you didn't offer any way to change it, right? And then also people just don't know what they fucking want anyway. The average person really doesn't fucking know what they want. Alright, I don't know what to do. I'm gonna do this for potential guppy. I fucked up. Yeah, I fucked up. Okay. Was there a tinted rock in that room? It looked like there was as I was leaving. But yeah, like, anybody can fucking point out flaws, right? Especially when they're opinion-based, which a lot of the WoW complaints happen to be, right? And so it's so stupid to, like, you know, hold your own opinion on a specific thing higher than anybody else's. Like, if I say, you know, if I say I'm enjoying playing WoW, and your response is, what are you enjoying doing? There's nothing to do. I would say, what fuck game are you playing? I have been kept busy the past month. You know, like, I haven't even thought about being bored. Like, the idea of being bored while playing WoW hasn't even occurred to me yet. You know? It's like, oh, stupid ketchup mechanics. I think those are fine. I have no personal problems with ketchup mechanics whatsoever. I think they're a perfectly reasonable thing. Now, if you talk about the difficulty of LFR, we have a different thing. That, I'll agree, is a little bit on the undertuned side. But it's also optional. You as a player are not ever required to do it. You could make an argument that you are required, but technically you don't have to. Technically you can just find a group of people who are progressing through, you know, the same content that you are and progress, instead of just doing LFR to skip it and move to the next thing. Please. I mean, like, you know, I'm not gonna disagree that there are a lot of negative decisions Blizzard has made in Warlords of Draenor, but fuck, dude. I'm still digging it, you know? There's shit to do. other than exactly raiding, you know? There always has been, there always will be. And that's WoW for you. Also, the amount of complaints I heard about professions just confuses the shit out of me, by the way. It just, I can't fathom what they're complaining about. It just doesn't make sense to me. Like, everybody that I hear complaining about it is like, professions are meaningless now. And I'm sitting over here making, you know, like, minimum fucking, like, 5k a day just from using gathering professions. And be like, professions are so useless now. Oh, God, I hate it. I hate what they did to them. I'm like, fuck, what? Huh? The point of a gathering profession has always been to make money by selling the fucking mats to people with crafting professions. And I'm making money. Not with the specific mats that you know, that the things give you. Like, if I'm mining some ore, I'm not mining for that ore. I mean, it's a nice bonus, but I'm mining for that fucking fell blight, motherfucker. Also, fishing for fell blight is pretty good. Skinning for fell blight is pretty good. So, I don't know. All the complaints I've heard, I'm scratching my head, you know? Seriously, I'm pretty sure all the complaints, well, not all, a lot of the complaints about WoW. Let me rephrase it. When I say all, I'm being hyperbolic. What I meant to say is most. I think most complaints about WoW in its current state come from people who don't even play the game. Like, they unsubbed, like, you know, in fucking Cataclysm, when I did. And then they've just never come back, but they're constantly just keeping an eye on it, you know? Constantly just watching and being like, I think this thing's bad. Like, they never experience it. They're just like, this is what I think. This is, you know. Or maybe they resub for a month and then realize that they just don't like WoW. Except instead of making the connection in their brain, they're like, the game must suck. You know? There's no way that I could dislike this game unless it fucking sucked, right? So it sucks. I don't know. It's always been a thing that boggled my fucking mind when people are like, this game's bad, and then you ask them, why is it bad? And their answer is always super opinionated. I mean, like, you know, I have fallen victim to that as well. I've definitely done that in my life. A number of times, in fact. But I have reached enlightenment, if you will. It sounds douchey to say it that way, but you know what I mean. I've reached a point in my life where I've begun to actually value opinion. Not, well, opinions are still valuable. It's not like they're completely pointless, but when speaking in an objective context about quality of something, you have to just leave your opinions at the door. Maybe make a note of them, right? But don't have that be the beginning and ending of your argument, because if it is, your opinion, it's pretty irrelevant in that context. In fact, it's entirely irrelevant in that context. The best that it can do is give a note, you know, to, oh, sweet. Sweet Jesus. Give a note to kind of, you know, give an idea of what stance you're taking, right? Like, that's probably the best thing it can do in that sort of situation. But, you know, people just fucking share their opinions as if it's an undeniable truth. Which is nothing new, in fairness. I guess I'll take this instead of counterfeit penny. Like, it's nothing new, it's just very frustrating, you know? Especially when it comes to discussing video games. Video games, people who play video games, I think, are the worst culprits of this. Of this bullshit of fucking, you know, the game is bad because I dislike it, you know? Obviously, they don't say exactly that, because hopefully, if they were to say exactly that, they'd have the self-awareness to be like, wait, am I retarded? And then just, you know, rewind and try to actually think about what would make a game bad. Because just, you know, the game is bad because I don't like it. That sounds so fucking pompous, you know? Oh, Jesus. But it happens all the time. Yeah, gimme. And fuck it. Hop the fuck in, spider bite. And once again, I want to say, as I'm describing this thing, please note, I am not entirely excluding myself. Right? I've done it. You know, in the past, I've done it. I've absolutely done it. I've been the person who says, this is bad because I don't like it. I've been that person. I think everybody has it there in their life at some point. I can't imagine what a person must have done in their life to have not ever been that person. Because whatever they did, they better fucking share their secrets. But it is incredibly frustrating to deal with. Part of being a rational thinking human being is understanding your own mistakes, you know? It's part of it. And that actually, that brings me on to a really interesting thing that I'll finish up really quick here, because the run's over. But, I was thinking about it, and so when I was in high school specifically is when this happened the most, because I never did my homework, so the situation cropped up a lot. But when somebody asks me a question, I like to answer the question, right? That's how I am. And most people would be like, yeah, no, that seems good. But the issue that I always ran into in high school was, it was like, Aiden, why didn't you do your homework? And I was like, oh, well, I was hanging out with friends. And I was like, that's not an excuse. I know, I wasn't trying to make it, I was telling you why I didn't do my homework because you asked that question, right? Like, that was what you asked me, so I answered it, you know? So, where's the problem? Like, I'm not using it as an excuse, obviously. Like, if I had an excuse, I would have told you before I showed up to class when I didn't do my homework. Like, if my mom was in the hospital, you know, I'd be like, yo, teach, ring him up on the good old dinosaur cell phone. Yo, teach, what up? Mama's in the hospital. I can't do my homework. And then my teach would be like, yo, that's cool, dog. We Gucci. And then that would be the story, right? That'd be an excuse. That would be an actual reason to not do it. But I still gave why I didn't do it, right? Because that's how I am. I like to answer questions. And it's very weird because people are generally not very upfront about things. If somebody asks you a question, quite often, they don't want the answer to that question. You know, not that it's rhetorical, it's more of just like, it's their own way of articulating how, you know, a question that they think will egg you on to what they want you to say, right? It's less of actually, hey, why didn't you do your homework? It's more of, hey, can you apologize for not doing your homework, you slacker? Right? Like, that's what they meant to say, but obviously they're way too professional to say that, you know? It's a very weird thing. Human nature is a bizarre thing. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed that episode. If you did, please be sure to leave a like. It does help me out a great deal. You know, comment as well, and subscribe, do all that shit. It's great. I love it. I do love it. I really do. Not only does it help expand the channel because my videos show up higher in suggested videos, but it also is just great because I like to know that there's this interaction. It's a two-way road, and it's not me just speaking to myself in front of my computer for 257 episodes. I like to know that there's actually people there, and I appreciate everybody who comments. I do read all the comments. Although recently YouTube's been super buggy and hasn't been showing them in my inbox, so I have to go to the videos manually. So if you're commenting on an older video, I might not get it. So, there's that. But I do read all the comments, even if I don't respond to them. So, anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I will see you in the next video tomorrow.